championship belongs to the Los Angeles Lakers.
Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. A few stories to dive into, one connecting Damian Lillard to your Los Angeles Lakers, and another one involving Anthony Davis and his three-point shooting. But first, quick reminder, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel, and don't forget to turn on those notifications as well. All right, let's start things off with the Damian Lillard story. Chris Haynes of Yahoo had an excellent long-form piece all about Damian Lillard, his decision to stay in Portland, how that all came about, all that sort of stuff. But within that story was a little bit about Lillard meeting with LeBron James and Anthony Davis over the offseason, sitting down talking about what it might be like to play together. And this has caused a little bit of a negative reaction towards the Lakers, towards LeBron, towards Anthony Davis from fans around the NBA. We've seen this. We've seen people saying, how much help does LeBron need? Things of that nature. Look, LeBron and AD sat down with Lillard, sounded very similar to what they did with Russell Westbrook when they were figuring out how they could work if the Lakers were able to make a trade for Westbrook. All three players sat down, talked about what things they could do on the court in order to make it fit. According to the story, Lillard essentially decided that the super team route was not a path that he wanted to go down, but they also recognized that there were going to be some real difficulties in terms of actually getting Lillard to the Los Angeles Lakers. There was no doubt that he could fit in. They felt the playing style would fit, no problems there. But Lillard coming to the Lakers, first and foremost, the Portland Trailblazers, they don't want to trade Damian Lillard. Second, they don't want to trade him to the Los Angeles Lakers. So add in those two things alone, and you've got a really difficult proposition there. They definitely don't want to trade him, but if they are going to trade him, they really don't want to trade him to the Los Angeles Lakers, who they see as one of, if not their biggest rival. I know the Lakers don't feel that way towards them, but that's the way the Blazers see the Lakers. And then, of course, the financial difficulties and value difficulties with making a deal work. The Lakers were able to trade for Russell Westbrook, who most see around the NBA as having a contract that's greater than his actual production on the floor. Not true with Damian Lillard. He carries a lot more trade value. So realistically, the Lakers didn't have the trade assets in order to make a deal work for Damian Lillard. And there's been a lot of chatter, a lot of eye rolling about, man, why would the Lakers even consider trying to make a trade for Damian Lillard? They must be ridiculous. They're completely out of touch, overvaluing their own assets. No, they knew that it was going to be a long shot to trade for him, but realistically, 29 teams around the NBA had at the top of their list for the offseason trade for Damian Lillard or trade for Bradley Beal. That was number one on the list for 29 NBA teams. And if it wasn't, then you're not doing your job properly. Regardless of how realistic the option is, everybody around the NBA is monitoring the situation with those two players. And right now, it sounds like both are going to stay put. Beal is going to stay in Washington. Lillard plans to stay in Portland. Now, that can change, of course, but right now, that seems to be where it's at. But teams, of course, are monitoring the situation because anytime a superstar comes on the market, if you're an NBA team and you don't at least explore how you could potentially land that player, then you are not doing your job. So to assume that the Lakers were the only team that was doing that is a major mistake, just like it's a mistake to assume that the Lakers are the only team sending tapes into the NBA about fouls. I saw this quite a bit yesterday with the story that the Lakers are sending tapes into the NBA to get them to review the fouls that aren't being called for them. And there was this reaction from fans of other teams saying, why are the Lakers crying for fouls? They shouldn't be a team that's crying for fouls. LeBron gets fouled all the time. Da 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 da. All this stuff, this backlash, why are we assuming the Lakers are the only team doing this? Yes, that story's out there that the Lakers are sending in tapes. Yes, they're actually doing it. Frank Vogel said it, but they're far from the only team. Every team does this. That's not an abnormal practice to send in clips where you felt like your team was wrong so the NBA can adjust the officiating accordingly. That's something that all teams are doing. That is not a uniquely Lakers thing, just like it's not a uniquely Lakers thing to consider pursuing Damian Lillard. And then on the LeBron front, how much help does LeBron need? Are we really going to fault LeBron James for trying to put together the best team he possibly can? That's what we're going to be upset with him for. Okay, but in any event, it's very clear that Damian Lillard is not going to become a Los Angeles Laker. We always knew it was going to be a long shot for that to happen. The Lakers simply didn't have the assets in order to make that move work, nor do the Blazers have the motivation to move him, nor is Damian Lillard asking out. So that is not going to happen, and obviously the Lakers moved on and got Russell Westbrook. Now, another story also came out regarding Anthony Davis's three-point shooting, and I think this is actually pretty important. AD has not been shooting well from three, 15% from three on the season. And it's still early, but after a rough three-point shooting season last year when he hit just 26%, it's becoming an increasing concern. And here's why it matters. As much as we tend to look at Anthony Davis at the center position as a cure-all, as something that will fix whatever problems the Lakers have, and don't get me wrong, I do think AD at the five is ultimately the path forward for the Lakers, particularly with their defensive versatility. If he's not shooting the three well on the offensive end of the floor, that robs you of some of the spacing you're ideally getting from playing Anthony Davis at center. If he's out behind the three-point line and teams no longer care because he's not hitting a high enough percentage of them, then you've got a bit of a problem. Now, I don't think it's happened yet. We're still right now at a point where teams see Anthony Davis behind the three-point line and they think, oh man, that's Anthony Davis. I have to guard him. But if his percentage stays this low for an extended period of time, teams will stop doing that. They will adjust. They will commit an extra player to the paint, and that's going to have a trickle-down effect where you're going to negatively impact some other players on the offensive end, namely Russell Westbrook. So nothing to panic about just yet. We're still very early in the season, but 15% from three right now for Anthony Davis, a poor shooting percentage there last season as well. It's something absolutely to keep an eye on. Now, Frank Vogel did have this to say about the situation. We're encouraging him to stay with the three-point shot and keep shooting those without hesitation. He's off to a slow start shooting the ball from three, but that's going to come around from him, and he's going to have an even bigger night. So the Lakers are encouraging Anthony Davis to continue shooting that shot, which is exactly what they should be doing. The only way he's going to improve his three-point percentage is by continuing to shoot it. Teams have to believe that he is a threat out there, and he's not going to hesitate to put that shot up. But something to watch moving forward, that percentage does need to come up, or else we're going to see defenses start to adjust and not defend him as much on the perimeter. But Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts about the Damian Lillard story, meeting with LeBron James and Anthony Davis, as well as AD's three-point shooting in the comments down below. Don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. If you guys want to follow me, you can find me on Twitter at @Trevor_Lane and on Instagram at @TrevorLaneNBA. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.